Sacramento City Clerk has rejected a petition which would have placed a new downtown arena on the ballot this June, saying the petition was, quote, insufficient, despite having more than 23,000 validated signatures. The battle over a new home for the Sacramento Kings may not necessarily be over. KCRA3's Kevin Oliver joins us live from Sacramento City Hall with more on why the petitions were ultimately rejected. Kevin.
That's right, Teo. The groups ultimately had more than enough valid signatures, but the city clerk found that found more than five problems with the petitions themselves that were turned in, and discovered at least 9 variations within all of those petitions that were signed by petitioners. Ultimately, the city clerk rejected one of the versions itself that cost more than 6,000 signatures because of the way that particular petition was worded. The city clerk said in a statement released this morning, "I find the petition non-compliant with significant provisions of the California Elections Code and the Sacramento City Charter, and therefore insufficient to move forward." The petitions were signed by thousands of people and would have forced the city to get voter approval for the $258 million subsidy for the Kings Arena. A vote would have happened in June. One of the leaders of Stop Sacramento Taxpayers Opposed to Pork was on the phone with their attorney when we caught up with them. They are evaluating their options and said they believe the issues that the city clerk raised were inadvertent errors and doesn't change the substance of the petition that was signed by all those voters.
We're advocates for them, you know. They signed in good faith. They want to see the election, and we want to see the election, and we'll see which is the best way to proceed.
Now, this very well could end up in court, and legal experts say if the case is sent to court, it would likely be put on the top of a judge's priority list because of the timing that needs to take place between now and Election Day and getting all of those ballots ready. It would likely take priority in terms of finding a decision. Teo?
Any idea on who the judge might side with here?
Well, in past cases, judges have sided mostly with the petitioners as long as the substance of the petition was clear and was the same as though the petition, the people signing that petition knew what they were signing. They have sided with the petitioners in those cases, saying that if there were inadvertent technical errors, they basically wanted to make sure that the petitioners weren't set aside and that they were heard. In this case, there are a number, 5 different issues that the city clerk has raised, and it'll ultimately be to a judge if it goes to court to determine whether those are substantive. Teo?
All right, more to come. Thank you, Kevin Oliver.